Hello, good morning, good evening, good night. You have once again rode that shiny, shiny seeker through the starways of space into the old oil house lock-in. With me today is one man. And it feels weird saying all the weird things to him when he's the only person in the room with me. So, for this week only, he gets a reprise.
Yay!
Name yourself, one man.
Chaos Envy!
Sorry, I should have really done that.
Name yourself, one man! A man with the power of one man! Almost as strong as Man-Man. But not quite, for he has the strength of a man, the speed of a man, and the agility of a man. Society has named him Man-Man. You, however, are one man.
Yes, but I was exposed as a child to X-rays. They proved that I was part skeleton and part man.
Which part's the skeleton part? It's quite obvious.
The skeleton part.
That's not special. I'm motherfucking Skeletor.
Warning, not safe for work. How are you doing?
Does that mean you're my daddy?
Fucking hope not. Get away from me, freak boy.
He runs around in underwear. Freakazoid, freakazee, freakazoo, chimpanzee. How are you doing, Rob?
I've just remembered that I've been watching that again recently.
Awesome.
It's scary.
Oh, it's brilliant.
No, it's scary.
Oh, yeah.
I'd forgotten about his hands marrying.
That was genius.
And then his feet were separated.
Yeah. It's the Candle Jack episode I love.
I don't think I've got that far.
Have you seen Candle Jack? The genius that is... Don't say his name! I'm not going to spoil it for you if you don't remember it. Okay.
No.
I was just wondering if that would... And, of course, the freaking genius that is the... what are they called? Is it the Adventure Brothers or something? Not the Venture Brothers, the Adventure. It's the one that's just basically a massive piss-take of Johnny Quest. And it has the amazing line of, "My God, it's huge! What are we going to do? Let me throw a barrel at it!"
I think I have actually seen those ones.
I may have to get some sound clips out for that one and intersperse them randomly throughout the show.
Yay!
Like we were a donut, an audio donut, with sprinklings of, "Let me throw a barrel at it!" Or maybe not then. And yes, I am indeed your host, Grufflock. But you should have guessed that now by the amount of nonsense that's been going on for 3 minutes and 6 seconds now.
Wow, that's a lot of precise nonsense.
Well, my nonsense is nothing but precise. I spend many hours thinking about something else. So yes, you have once again rode into the old oil house lock-in. Or as it is on the Full Metal Hero blogs, the old oil house presents the lock-in. Or, as it is on the Nerdsphere, Old Oil House, lock in. I don't have to put too much effort into that one. They are indeed a franchise of ours.
Yes, this is very true. We do own the Nerdsphere.
The boss himself said so.
If he said it, it must be true.
Indeed. If Uncle Timey said it, because you can believe everything Uncle Timey says, he wouldn't lie to you.
Even that thing about me having to pay him money.
Yes. If he said it, you must have to pay him money. And he agreed crappily to pimp you out at AA. To men.
Oh, what?
Do you not read that?
No.
Should we spend more time on Twitter?
I get worried when people start talking about pimping me out.
Well, yeah, time he said it. Must be true. So, yeah. No stew this week, I'm afraid. but we'll come to that. Sorry, one second. There we go. Sorry about that. But we'll come to that later on. But first, I'm going to ask you a question, Mr. Rob.
Ooh.
A question that spans the entirety of creation.
Hmm.
And one that will make you think to yourself, what is the very nature of reality?
Ah.
My question's this. What have you got this week that you didn't have last week? Because if you had it last week, you could have talked about it last week. But last week you didn't have it, so you couldn't talk about it last week. Since then you got it this week. Yes.
Oh, my brain just shut down. That was too much heavy thinking.
Oh, okay. In that case, I'll ask you a simpler question.
Yeah.
What do you have this week that you did not have last week? Because last week you had it, you were talking about last week, and so you got it this week instead.
Nothing.
You got a pizza?
Yeah, but that was part of my grocery shopping.
No. No Cyberverse.
Thankfully, no Cyberverse.
No Cyberverse. Which reminds me, actually, I need to talk to you about Cyberverse. There you go.
No, actually, it's been... there is something I may be purchasing later on in the week.
Do you want to share, or are you going to keep it as a secret for next week?
I may just keep it as a secret for next week, because I say I may be purchasing it, but I'll have to check the funds.
Okay, okay. What franchise is it from? Just give it a hint. A little bit of a hint.
Is it a Blu-ray?
Debbie Does Dallas.
No.
Pirates.
I would love that on Blu-ray.
Yeah. Not the only one.
And
because he is the greatest pirate hunter ever.
It's strangely not just because of the gorgeous naked ladies.
No. Oh,
I actually find that film fantastically funny.
It's the, probably the one of the few films I have watched in my life where I fast forward the sex scenes.
Yeah. All of them?
Most of them. I'm not gonna put myself in a position where I have to answer those questions. Not gonna do that. But oh, the little Japanese lady.
The first mate.
Maybe. yeah, but this is not a porn podcast. No. This is a podcast.
Well, if anyone out there...
But if this was a porn podcast, it would possibly be the finest porn podcast in the world.
If anyone, you know, out there is...
Watching porn.
Looking for a new movie to watch. And Pirates is a fantastic movie. The highest budget for a porn film ever.
I would like to point out that it was Mr. Rob here who handed this film over to me.
Something
wrong with you.
It was somebody at work that told me that after Pirates of the Caribbean came out, there was a pirate porno that came out, and I was just intrigued. I went and found it and went, dear God, this is funny.
It
does have better CG than some Hollywood blockbusters.
It's got better writing than some Hollywood blockbusters.
It's very true.
It's quite a freaky. I just wanted to point out that I got three films off you in this run. One was Superman Doomsday. One was Ninja Gaiden. One was a porn film about pirates.
Which was the best film out of the three?
Wasn't Superman Doomsday.
That was so bad.
Freaking awful.
I wanted it to be so good.
Yeah, it was just... Yeah.
And I don't know if it's just because I don't know anything about the character apart from he's awesome. He had an awesome lever, but it was so awesome that it broke off. But Ninja Gaiden I just didn't quite get.
No.
I thought he was supposed to be a super ninja who went around doing ninja-y things.
I was more pissed off that it had nothing to do with the game. That's the bit that really pissed me off. But Gaiden is story, isn't it? It was ninja story is the entire thing. Which reminds me, actually, there was a great thing on Twitter earlier on in the week. Because I think it was JD managed to read... He mistyped RoboCop.
Oh, to Robot Cop.
Yeah. It has brought me back to the point where I wish I was about 8 and my dad had got the wrong film out of the local VHS rental place in Sharjah, where he'd actually got a film called Robot Cop. It's entirely in Chinese, if memory serves me rightly.
Awesome.
And it was all about like this guy who was... He died. And he was brought back. And his son was being chased by drug dealers. So he came back as this robot cop. And came back to say... It was weird.
That sounds awesome.
From it, there was no subtitles or anything, so I'm not entirely sure what the point was. But
did you just watch it, hoping that if you listen to it long enough, you might understand it?
I think I was too young to even think that. I was just watching this freaking awesome Chinese dude with a robot head fighting people. Because we're talking, it was proper Power Rangers suit that he was wearing. It was brilliant. Anyhow, I digress. Myself, before I digress, speaking of Superman Doomsday, have you seen the trailer yet for Batman Year One?
No.
Nom 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 nom.
If it's as good as
Carry on.
If it's as good as Under the Red Hood, I'll be happy.
Mm-hmm. It looks good. It looks very... But I've been burnt before.
Mm-hmm.
I think so far, Under the Red Hood's probably my favourite of the animated movies.
Oh, that was so good.
It really was. Mm. Well, Mask of the Phantasm first, but that's a different...
Right, because it's...
That's my favourite DC animated movie.
It's because it's got fond memories.
And it's an amazing film.
Mm-hmm.
I also quite like Batman Sub-Zero. That was a good film. Even though it was just an elongated episode, it wasn't a proper...
Is that not just because of your love of the guy who does the voice for Mr. Freeze?
Possibly. And just the Mr. Freeze character in general. Like, freaking... Yes, we're padding. Just the Mr. Freeze character in general. So, yeah, myself, I got the following. I haven't actually bought anything this week. This is just stuff that I've been waiting for that has arrived. I got a knockoff Sunstorm. I have a knockoff Sunstorm for one reason and one reason only. Hasbro haven't released a Sunstorm. So I now have a Sunstorm for my classic Seekers. My brother, the little bastard that he is trying desperately to make me buy the three-piece Rainmaker set. There's a three-piece knockoff Rainmaker set.
Okay.
You know, the three that turn up in one of the episodes. There's a green one, a purple one, and a yellow one, I think. And they're what Sunstorm and Acid Storm were based off.
Don't remember that.
They're in Turn of Horn scene.
Hmm.
And the entire reason that Acid Storm is called Acid Storm is because I believe it's Wheeljack shouts, "Acid Storm, it's melting me," or something. Or Acid Rain, or something. I can't fucking remember. It's been a while. It's not one of my favourite episodes. It's not Call of the Primitives. So I got him. Because the shipping was freaking ridiculous, I thought, bugger it, I'll throw an extra one in. And I got the knockoff Sunstreaker mold called Deep Cover. I really like him.
Is he supposed to be a Decepticon?
No, he's not a bot. He's a Diaclone recolor. Basically, there's a Diaclone, an e-hobby, I think it was, Diaclone version of Sideswipe called Deep Cover. There was three. Deep Cover, Tiger Tracks, and another one whose name escapes me. Mm. I quite like Deep Cover. To me, he actually looks like he should be head of security.
Mm.
For some reason, the face looks a lot meaner than the Sideswipe one. I don't know. I really like him. I think he's cool. And in official, I got a freaking Warpath for less than 20 quid.
Kablammo!
I couldn't be more pleased. Once again, Ratchet's Clinic comes through. Honestly, go to eBay, hunt down Ratchet's Clinic, give the guy some business, because honestly, I don't think I've met a better seller. I'm thinking after AA, I'm going to go and spend a lot of money in his eBay store. Because he's got a couple of bits and pieces going in there, which I really want.
Cool.
Yeah. Otherwise, I got some comics as well. And I don't normally mention the comics I get. But I got myself Lady Mechanica issue 2. 4 months after issue 1 came out, I finally got issue 2.
Not too far behind then.
No. It's good. Honestly.
Is it 4 months worth of good?
Not particularly. But as the story goes, it's very, very good. I am enjoying it. And I bought the first 2 issues of Batman Knight of Vengeance. Yeah. That's very good. I'm not going to spoil anything to you, because I really don't want to spoil anything at all. The last page of issue 2 was a bloody blinder. I'll show you later.
Awesome.
In fact, I'll show you now if you want. 1 second. Live on the air, you're getting this reaction. So you need to go down that page and then turn the page. I know this isn't enthralling listening, but I just want Rob's view on something. I'll just fill up some dead air now. Da, 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 da.
Oh, holy shit.
Yeah, how fucked up is that? But we'll talk about that off the air.
Wow.
So yeah, go get Batman Night of Vengeance Parts 1 and 2. And Part 3 is out not too far off, actually.
Speaking of superheroes, apparently Green Lantern isn't supposed to be getting a sequel.
It isn't, now.
Becca was just saying to me before, I don't know where she's got this from, but apparently it didn't make enough money to get a sequel.
I thought a sequel was already greenlit, to be honest with you. Oh, well,
obviously, if they didn't get the money, they're not going to do a sequel.
No, true. Oh, well, in other words, let's just get Ryan Reynolds in as the fucking Flash after all.
No, Deadpool.
I don't care about Deadpool. I want Ryan Reynolds as the Flash.
No.
I've always wanted Ryan Reynolds to play the Flash.
I think he's good for Deadpool.
He is good for Deadpool, but...
he needs to do that first and get that movie out of the way.
I don't trust Deadpool film.
Well,
I won't trust a Deadpool film unless you've got Deadpool talking to the audience.
Now, that was one of the big things about the script that the guys who were writing it were saying about, was they were going to break the fourth wall quite a lot.
Yep, you have to.
The thing that me and my mate were talking about in work, we decided what we'd do for the teaser trailer for Deadpool. He'd just have like a warehouse or something.
Mm-hmm.
He'd have like this Celine Dion-esque ballad track going on.
Right.
And you just have all these ninjas sort of like running in. And when you actually get in there, you see ninjas flying backwards and blood splattering everywhere and thing going on. And then you get to like the really powerful bit of the song of the... she's screeching about, you know, whatever lost love or anything. And you just... the camera pans across. And you see this ninja just get booted. And there's Deadpool with an iPod on. With a ninja in a headlock just wiping a tear away underneath his mask. And then he puts his hand back down, pulls the trigger and shoots him in the head and just carries on killing.
I would do it a different way entirely.
It would either be that or the one of just a TV screen. Holmes reporting on a murder and everything. Real serious kind of, you know, this person was shot, you know, violent crime, blah, blah, blah. As it's playing, you pan out so you see it's an actual TV, old school tube TV, in a dark room. You pan round; it's a grubby little sort of bedsit type room, very sort of sparsely decorated or just shit everywhere.
Right.
And it pans round, and just as it gets to the armchair that's in front of the. Thing, you hear the name suspected hired assassin Deadpool involved, and you just kind of like you get the thing as it pans round, and there sat in the chair is Deadpool in his underwear with popcorn and a beer and just a mask up over his nose, and he just like just looks at the camera and goes, what?
I would do it a completely different way. I would put him into other teaser trailers,
like there'd be Stitch.
Kind of, yeah. But I'm talking... do you remember the Godzilla trailer? The Godzilla teaser where they had the big foot come down and destroy the dinosaur? It's like Deadpool jumping on the way going, damn, I'm glad I wasn't in that film.
That would be good.
Just like that. The Batman Returns one, you've got like the bat symbol unfolding and you've got Deadpool sort of being slowly pushed out of the screen. It's like, oh my God!
The what you call it one. Do you remember the Spider-Man one they did?
Yes, with the Twin Towers.
No, the Spider-Man one where they were doing that. They play the music and they've got all the sort of webbing in the background with the Shear go for a spin with the World
superhero.
And it turned out it was Yoda. And it's them plug-in thing. And everyone in the cinema went crazy.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
That would be a cool one to do with Deadpool. To steal somebody else's trailer.
Just looks down and goes, the hell are you? You little green freak. Yeah, well, I've got another question for you then.
What's that?
Mr. Rob.
Yeah.
Mr. Rob.
Yes.
Mr. Anderson.
Yep.
I see you're swallowing the red pill.
You help your landlady out with her garbage.
I think you and me need to have a little bit of a chat, because you see... Mr. Anderson, I'm Megatron! Come to me, boy! Pretending more to Captain Nook there from Peter Pan and the Pirates. Why hasn't Tim Curry ever voiced Megatron?
Because it'd just be horrific.
It'd be awesome.
It'd be horrific because everyone would be swooning over Megatron.
Give me the cube, boy.
Boy.
Boy. I am a scholar, a gentleman.
And a psychopath.
Look at my murder ref arm. This is my gun arm, boy. Is your refrigerator running? Well, you better catch it, boy, before it runs away.
Quite.
I can't think of any more Tim Curry. He's been in fucking everything and I can't think of any more. So, question. We've got a Twitter challenge.
We do have a Twitter challenge.
What is your Twitter challenge?
Seeing as how Mr. Shu is absent without leave.
Is he?
Stu. Stu. Here, boy. Here, boy. Got some biscuits.
No, he's not there.
Thank God you didn't start doing the thing from Evolution. I was half expecting you to start going, "You are so beautiful."
Oh, good. Another song.
To me.
There's only one song to sing at this point. Just, pardon me. Just the two of us. Building castles in the sky. Just the two of us.
You and I.
Shut up, you fool. You call this a duet? I've seen better duets when Beastman farts.
So anyway.
It's just the two of us.
Shut up.
I hate musicals.
Because Mr. Stew is absent without leave, what is he doing to keep him away from this show?
I'm saying he's building a lifelike construction, lifelike, life scale, everything construction of himself to send to work so he doesn't have to go anymore. In other words, he's making bitch stew.
I think...
Bitch stewy?
I think he has run away from this show, gotten a boat, and gone to some nameless city in America to fight an underground fight to help pay his dead brother's sister.
I've worked it out. He's living in Mexico. He's living in Mexico, where his sagas and his stories delight the children and the old. If he gets too angry, he turns into the Hulk. I say angry, upset, happy. He's going to keep very level planned.
Is it a bit like a swamp dragon in that
respect? I've gone from Mexican to pirate, and I'm not entirely sure why.
He's a bit like a swamp dragon in that respect.
Aye, he's one of them, lad, aye. You best start believing in swamp dragon stories. Stew's in one.
I love the swamp dragons. In fact, if they get happy, they blow up. If they get sad, they blow up. If they get excited, they blow up. You've just got to keep them placid.
It's like the first time you ever hear about swamp dragons. They're looking at a map. Well, Ridgely's looking at a map. I'm sorry, we're talking Discworld, by the way. Ridgely's looking at a map and just goes, "What's it says here? Here be dragons." Oh, I'm sorry, Guard Chancellor. That's Lady Ramkin's sanctuary for six swamp dragons. Oh, okay. Why does it say it again down here? Oh, that would be a lie, sir. Alright, well, with the Twitter challenge being set up, should we have some news?
Let's have some news.
Cue the news! Right then, I'm taking over for Stu. And I've just got a multimedia message from Mr. Logan Blaze. I'm scared to see what it is.
Don't open it.
I'm a bit... Paul, you're a freaking star.
Dare I ask?
I'll show you it later. It's nothing bad. It's just, it's quite good. It's quite good. Right, so. News! News item number one. IDW to start providing... IDW... Fucking hell, Adam. IDW Publishing to provide digital copies of print comics.
Ooh.
Yeah, any thoughts on that one? Because I think... I'll read out the full story. Looks like comic fanatics with iPhones will be able to make... to get double... My God, Adam. There was a point where I could read. You know that, don't you? I could speak too.
Mm-hmm.
Looks like comic fanatics with iPhones will be able to get double goodness with every comic purchase made at your local comic shop this coming fall. According to Sabertron.com, Tipster Coolio, IDW Publishing will be working with Diamond Distributors so that their purchases of hard stock comic books will be able to receive a digital copy. My phone's just gone off and I can't read anymore. A digital copy of books at no charge. So yeah,
I've never liked reading comics on a screen.
No, I'm not a fan of it.
I like to have it in
front
of me. I want the tangible paper.
You know, the other problem with digital comics is,
mm-hmm.
if it takes off in the way that IDW, DC, Marvel wanted to, mostly DC, DC seem to really want it to work, it's going to cause major problems for the smaller comic distributor. Mm-hmm. Our local comic store, I was talking to him, and he has one question. What, in the entire line of stuff that DC's got planned for the next year, does it do for him?
Yeah.
Why should he carry DC Comics? Oh, obviously they sell, so that's one reason. But why should he carry DC Comics when they're making the... they want to make this jump to digital? Because he's end up just going to end up with stock he can't sell. Simple as. Next. Kapow Toys are going to drop the Dark of the Moon line.
What?
Seriously. One second, let me just load it up. Right. From the Facebook, it says, sadly, this is from Kapow Toys Facebook, sadly, we are not going to carry on supporting the Dark of the Moon line due to a number of reasons. One, extremely poor UK distribution at wholesale level, meaning some retailers are still waiting on Wave 1 item 2. Sorry, on Wave 1 items. Two, poor case assortments. Three, slow sales. 4. Larger chains doing deals with which we cannot begin to compete. 5. No notification or sales on upcoming products. We will, however, continue to support the Dark of the Moon Human Alliance line, Leaders, and the Takara Tomy exclusives. So, yeah.
Is that their way of saying we think they're shit?
No, it's their way of saying how the hell do we compete against that thing that Tesco's was doing. Yeah. You know? I can understand what's going on here. Oh, let's face it, this is the UK. We're going to get shafted.
We always seem to, which is a bit of a pain in the backside.
I sometimes wonder if Hasbro actually wants UK fans.
Yeah.
But that's going back to Mr. Hasbro, if you remember him. I'm Mr. Hasbro! I control the toys. I made it so Ironhide's head doesn't come completely out of its stupid little body. Mr. Hasbro wins again. Take that, geeks. I make movies now. Turd.
Stu makes it look so easy.
He really does. Sorry, I'm having difficulty in getting everything together. So yeah, any thoughts on that?
I just feel sorry for them.
Yeah.
So, I mean...
at least Human Alliance. You can still get Human Alliance from one place in this country, being Kapow.
Yeah.
Because it's not fucking Argos. They hold the exclusives for the Human Alliance toys. Still haven't fucking seen any. I want them.
Mm.
Unfortunately, the more time that goes by without Argos stocking them, the less chance there is of me buying that load. Because when I first saw them, if they'd been in Argos, I would have probably gone in and bought the line.
Yeah.
That's how much I want them. But as time's going on and it's getting harder and harder to find them, because I don't really want to go and spend the silly amounts of money that they are on eBay.
Yeah.
Because they're going to be in Argos. Well, they're meant to be in Argos. They're going to be like £4 cheaper.
Yeah, it's a bit stupid.
It's irritating. It's really irritating. Next up, there's a Dark of the Moon Voyager Shockwave repaint. Have you seen it?
No.
It's not purple. It's blue and silver. Oh, blue and grey. There you go. That's it. That's it there.
It's shit.
Yep.
I don't like the design for...
It's a movie toy. We've talked about the aesthetic many a time. The problem I've got with it is, I've got a horrible feeling it's going to be called Galvatron. No.
It's not Galvatron.
No. Add that to the fact that... I mean, a lot of people are saying good things about Dark of the Moon Shockwave, which is fair enough. It does look like it's a good toy, but I'm with you on the boat where... I'm not a huge fan of the aesthetic, the movie aesthetic.
Mm.
And due to my lack of space and the fact that I refuse to... Well, these days, I refuse to buy anything other than the one line that I collect. Because I granted, I'd love to have a full animated line. Don't have the space and the funds, though. You know, if I had a full animated line, I would be hunting down the BotCon set.
Yeah.
I have no willpower. So I don't collect the animated line. I just collect the chuggets. As I say, I've heard really good things about it. And I wouldn't mind having a fiddle with one. But I don't really want to buy it. And when you do such a horrible hash job... I did see someone somewhere saying that they thought it was a prototype. But no, that would just be solid grey. Much like you looked in the film.
Yeah.
Next up, Sideburn is shipping. If you're a member of the TFCC, Sideburn is shipping. I'm a member of the TFCC. Sideburn is shipping. Can I have a fucking Sideburn, please?
I've been waiting a while.
Just a little bit. It's not their fault. There was a problem with customs.
Mm.
So, and then finally.
Finally!
A little bit of third party news.
Ooh.
The Corbot V Carnage Axe. One second. There is a picture here, and I'm unsure how this picture. Yeah, that's the one. Right, there you go. The Carnage Axe. It's the Thing Axe recolored. The Cobalt V. Was it just called the War Axe?
Mm.
Yeah, whatever it's called. Recolored for into Nemesis colours. Oh, yeah, I think some of that.
I still want that. That's fine. I just want to have that axe.
I want that one. And I want that one so I can put it on my Scourge. Not my Scourge, sorry, my Toxitron that I've been working on. I want to arm that Toxitron to the teeth.
Nice.
I'm going to sculpt him a plunger at some point.
Oh,
so he's got one of them as well. Any thoughts on that one?
I do like it.
Uh-huh.
I really do like it, but I think I want the original. If I'm going to buy one, I want the original to go with the War Within Prime.
What about if it was a Nemesis Prime? Would you be interested in a Nemesis Prime?
I would be interested in Nemesis Prime.
Would you be interested in a Nemesis Prime? How about a two-pack with a Prime and a Megatron?
Mm-hmm.
We could do a little bit of a deal here.
Don't. Stop it.
A little bit of a deal.
Stop it. Stop it.
Because there's a Megatron there that I wouldn't mind.
Stop it.
A little bit of a deal.
Stop it. Stop.
Alright, you go right ahead and buy that. Without me.
I don't actually have a Prime.
Yeah, oh, that's weird.
I don't have a Prime. And I think the only Prime I'm really kind of taken with is that War Within. Not War Within.
The
War for Cybertron.
I was going to call it Gears of War. No, that's not right.
Yeah, it's...
Oh, I completely forgot to say before. I went to see Harry Potter. Carry on. Gears of War, Gears of Wand, Harry Potter.
Gears of War. I think that's the only Prime I'm really sort of like taken with, and I think that axe really suits it.
Mm.
So,
well, there's a 3-pack coming out that has Prime, Bumblebee and Megatron in it, which I wouldn't mind, because that Megatron looks like a decent stand-in for Universe Galvatron. The way the colours are in it, I wouldn't mind. Put the Galvatron head on him, you know?
Yeah, see where you're going with that.
See how that works.
Yeah, see where you're
going. Then the Bumblebee, of course. Do something with it. And then the Prime, I wouldn't mind, but Megatron gun on his arm and called him Giltar. You don't know Giltar?
No.
You may want to go to the TF Wiki and type in Giltar.
Okay, I'll have a look at that later.
Okay. He's a freaking ace. Fusion of Megatron and Prime. But he's also Starscream. Made by Quintessons. They did it.
Quintesson Wizards did it.
Quintesson Wizards did it. But there's also the Dark Side one, which comes with a Nemesis Prime and a Black Megatron, which I love that Black Megatron.
Nemesis Prime is black, is he not?
Yes, they're both black. It might not actually be Nemesis Prime, it's Black Prime. But anyway, new meta. So, with that, that's all of the news. Just having a quick check just to make sure that's all of the news that got my interest. No. There's one from last week. Here's a bit of news for you. Walmart listings. Shows that later on this year there will be a Black Shadow and a Junkion figure.
Ooh.
Obviously, the Black Shadow is going to be a redo of the Thunderwing figure.
Mm.
Space gangster! But the space mafia! And the Junkion's going to be a Wreck-Gar. More Junkions for the pile!
Calm yourself.
Troop building, man! Troop building. I've got to. Oh, bloody hell, I completely forgot. I got a United Wreck-Gar through the post this week as well. Forgot about him. Should have brought him with me. I'm sorry.
No, you wouldn't have left the house with it.
Why?
You know Becca's desperate for a Wreck-Gar.
That's a good point. I'm glad I didn't. My self-preservation must have kicked in and went, nope, you don't have that. I hope you didn't hear that. I'm through the wall. Give me! Are you going to pick up a Black Shadow and a Junkion?
I don't think I'd do the Junkion. Obviously, I'm after a Wreck-Gar for the missus. To be honest, I'm not that bothered about the Black Shadow.
What? Why? Black Shadows.
Doesn't...
Space Mafia.
Doesn't do anything for me, dude.
I know who you want. I know who you want in a Generations line. I know exactly who you would buy in a heartbeat the moment he came out.
Who's that?
Sixshot, Decepticon Ninja Consultant.
Yes, especially if it said Decepticon Ninja Consultant, because it would have Ninja in the title.
Yeah, well,
I would have to have it.
They've probably lost the name to Sixshot by this point. So they'd have to call him Decepticon Ninja Consultant Sixshot. Like Solar Storm Grappel.
Grappel.
Grappel. Well, that's all the news then. I hope that Stu doesn't hurt me. There wasn't a huge amount, I'm afraid. Not much at all. Alright then.
Go get him, Dragon Walker! Go!
Dragon Walker, Battle Armor, He-Man, and Skeletor and Merman each sold separately.
Step right, you slay, He-Man!
Batteries not included.
Watch that! Dragon Walker! Take that, He-Man! May the mightiest power prevail!
New Dragon Walker vehicle for use with most Masters of the Universe figures. Action figures each sold separately. From but.
Dragon Blaster.
One more paralyzing Dragon Blast, and what? Freeze, Fisto!
Dragon Blaster, Skeletor, Fisto, Roboto, and He-Man figures, each sold separately.
Roboto, attack!
Your Dragon Blaster can't stop the most powerful robot in the universe.
Oh, yeah? Freeze, Roboto! I said freeze!
Dragon Blaster Skeletor, new from the Masters of the Universe collection. Other action figures, each sold separately. From Mattel.
Mr. Rob, I've got a question for you. It's one of many questions I have asked you this evening.
Okay, hit me.
Mr. Rob, do you have a Chaos Corner? Because you're a wild child, gotta love you. I want you.
Yes, I do have a Chaos Corner.
Because in X, I need you to love me. Because I want what you do.
A Chaos Corner that will shock
you. I'm a machine and I want your love.
It will shock you to your very core.
Excellent! Is it Rick Astley again?
No.
Oh.
I was just flicking through the TF Wiki, as I do, looking for my Chaos Corner.
Mm-hmm.
And I came across Override Prime.
Now, okay.
The first thing that made me stop was the horrendous animated sort of pick. It just jumped out and kind of went at me.
One of them.
Yeah. And it's basically... says, Override Prime is an Autobot from the Animated Continuity family.
The Magnus Cluster.
Override Prime was the Autobot bonded to Kappa Supreme, the 11th of the Omega Sentinels, and the only female.
I have no idea what that meant. What did you just say to me? Seriously. I don't know. We could have just been doing a foxtrot or something. I have no idea what you've just said.
Do you want me to repeat it?
Yes.
The whole thing?
Go on.
Override Prime was the Autobot bonded to the Kappa Supreme, the 11th of the Omega Sentinels, and the only female.
What the fuck's a Zamoflange?
The
only female in what?
It just says the only female.
All right.
Override's connection to Kappa Supreme was presumably lost when the Sentinel blew up, assuming she was not on board her ship when it was destroyed. Transformers animated the Allspark Almanac. In the notes, I did quite like this. This is the one thing that made me think, right, I'm sticking with this.
Okay. Other than to see the bafflement on my face.
Yes. In the notes, she's the first female Prime in Transformers history. Not that it actually means anything in the animated universe where primes are a dime a dozen and outranked by a Magnus. But hey, it's something.
That's true. Although I'd like to see Prime become a female Prime. Hey, Rodimus. You're out of the protector armor? Yeah. Is it ready? Well, no. And yes, but no. Because you see, Prime, every time you put the Matrix in your chest kind of grows. That's because I become a hero, ready to fight. No, but it turns you into a girl. We have to start calling you Rodimus. Now, that doesn't even make sense, Wheeljack. I know. I'm due a win, Mrs. Prime. I'm due a win.
The only other thing it says is, as her name...
Optimus! Take off the dress!
As her name and appearance obviously indicate, she's based on the character of the same name from the Cybertron series. Mm. And it says underneath the picture, primary weapon, the sound of her sharpened helmet scraping the glass ceiling.
Oh. Nice. Nothing like a little bit of sexism before tea.
Yes. Oh dear. That was just... I think it was the...
I think you need to have a second one. I think you need to type in Giltar now. and just look at Giltar.
Okay. The reason I picked that one was just the fact that it had that little dig at primes in animated, because they are just everywhere.
Well, name me three.
Sentinel, Optimus, Rodimus.
Damn, I meant to say four. Booger booger bollocks. Name me four. Come
long
on.
Long arm.
Was he a prime? Was he
long arm? Long arm prime.
Bollocks he was, wasn't he? Oh, shut your face, you smarmy smiling bastard.
Oh, no, not even a big animator.
Come here and let me punch you. Then go over there and let me throw chairs at you. And come back here and I'll kick you in the head.
Is it spelled how it sounds?
Yes.
G. I. L.
Cue transition music.
Gun on one arm, like a giant sniper rifle. He's got a cannon on his shoulder. And he's got a gun on his other arm. He's loaded to the nines.
If you look on the site, I think I've got pictures of it on the site. I built an animated one for my brother. Because I love Giltar. And I've just been waiting patiently.
He is quite cool. So is he a Decepticon then?
He's Quintesson. It's the body of Prime and Megatron fused, but has the spark of Starscream. If you look at the pictures of him, if you look at the face underneath the faceplate, just where the eyes are, you'll notice something really weird. It's not not Prime's face, it's Megatron's underneath the helmet and the faceplate.
Huh. That's quite cool.
I love Giltar. He's one of those characters that it just really captures me. As I say, I want a War for Cybertron Prime to turn into him.
Nice.
But I want him to have War for Cybertron Megatron's cannon.
And legs.
And legs. Well, I think, honestly, just paint the thing legs black. The Prime legs black, and I'm happy with that.
Fair dues.
Right, well, unfortunately, all we have left in our weekly bits before we go to the Twitter is a grinding of gears.
Yes.
Do you want to take that one, or shall I?
It's up to you.
I'll take it, because you've got the Twitters.
Okay.
The Twitters. One second. Mr. Black Shadow is part of the Space Mafia. He likes to go around and shoot all the people who don't break the rules or the laws, because he's an idiot with a gun. He's an idiot with a gun. I'm singing this song while I'm waiting for this to load. Doesn't matter now because I've almost done it. All I've got to do is it for this little bit. It's my song. Logan Blaze asks a ninja consultant.
Okay. The general ability to do long-distance trading is getting on my fucking arse. We have already had more problems with postage, and eBay itself is getting more and more twatting expensive and developing TCs. TC? TNCs. Trades and conditions, which screw you over. Now me and my friends are having trouble with PayPal. Odd transactions, money going missing, taking back money without checking first, it all sucks. You would use a postal order, but that means posting, and we get the same problems again. Same for checks, which are going to be phased out in a few years. So, if people want to trade now, their lives are put into one huge game of Russian roulette. Except this time, only one bullet is missing, and the gun is being fired by a triple-headed demon of Banks, eBay, and the Royal Mail. Fuck them all! For them all in their asses now!
I agree. PayPal has pissed me off quite royally this last week. Seriously fucking pissed me off. And
I'm not surprised after what you told us.
Yeah, I'm not going to go into it there because it's... I don't really want to go into it on air, but yeah, there was some major issues with PayPal. And of course, there's some major issues with the post office because there are some bits and pieces, which I'm mostly annoyed about because something I was going to do for someone just because they really wanted it, then the item never actually arrived and has been lost somewhere. So you can't send stuff through the post. I can't send stuff through the post now without it being recorded, which is frickin' expensive.
Yeah.
Horrible. But yeah, I agree with you there, Paul. I agree with you wholeheartedly. So should we get a Twitter readout then?
Yep.
Because this is going to be a short damn show this week, I think.
Well, we've got a fair few tweets.
Marvellous.
I shall just load them up.
Loading up the tweet.
So, the question was, seeing as how Mr. Stu is absent without leave, what is keeping him away from doing his job on the show?
No.
So, we shall start off with Mr. Timey to Wimey, who says he has to blow dry his hair. Oh, wait.
Yeah, that doesn't work. That doesn't work. That doesn't work.
Cybertronax.
Ah, Sean himself.
Says, I hear you being picked to fight the Mantis Men.
He might be onto something there. I've been listening to Mysterious Universe. I know the weird shit that goes on in this world. Speaking of which, Nicole, Beatles Diva herself, the Hailstorm, turned me on to Mysterious Universe.
Mm.
It's really good. Really, really good show. Don't ever fucking fall asleep listening to it, though. Woke up at 5 o'clock in the morning and the guy is reading a quite atmospheric extract of a guy who was abducted, well, apparently abducted by aliens. You're half asleep. You wake up and there's this voice, this quite menacing voice, saying things like, and then they spread my legs apart and the probing device was come. I could see the alien's eyes. Fucking terrified was I.
Dr. Melski says, Gruffy has him chained up in the dungeon, forcing him to live through through multiple fantasy worlds at once.
I am indeed.
That's quite horrific.
You know which fantasy world it is, don't you? It's the one that we used to do RPGs in.
No, dear God. That would kill anyone.
Hello! Tacky Jackie! Sorry, it's a bit of an in-joke there. Speaking of which, me, Mr. Melski, and Tricky were actually talking about RPGs.
I noticed.
Tricky came up with a fucking genius idea.
Mm.
I may have to clone myself. I want to be part of that, but God damn it. Anyway, carry on.
Timey to Wimey says, Shocker kidnapped him and turned him into a modified human. He is now known as Harem Rider.
Harem Rider, would that be?
Yes.
Excellent. He rides thousands of women. Oh.
Damn it!
Hentai!
Dr. Melski, he's undergoing treatment for the P virus. I've heard that can take some time.
Oh, me too. It's almost as bad as brain weasels.
Ooh.
Mm. Yeah, if you don't catch the P virus as fast as possible, you indeed start turning into a pony. And start wandering around with a gun for an arm, going, stars!
Did you...
And then you become Yul Brynner.
Did you know that... Well, did you see the picture I put up about the P virus getting into video games?
Yes.
Yeah. I found out what that was.
Mm-hmm.
Spoiler alert, when you complete Red Faction Armageddon,
right,
you actually get a My Little Pony for your gun. Mm. And the way you fire it is by lifting up its tail.
Oh, so much like a real pony then. Next!
It sounds quite horrific, but apparently it's a very powerful gun. Even though it does shoot rainbows and stars out of its ass.
Didn't J.K. Rowling write that book?
Possibly.
Mm.
Cybertronix again. I hear he has the power to melt.
To melt?
I think that was at Timey's comment.
Oh.
At the Harem Rider.
Yes.
Of
course. Because melting helps in that.
It just says, at Timey T. Wimey at the Old Oil House, so.
Puzzled.
Very.
Sean, I want to hear more about this melting problem that you suffer from. Do you suffer from premature melting? When you find yourself alone with a lady, do you, in those occasions, do you find yourself melting? Do you find yourself melting like a small Mars bar on a hot day? Maybe a candle that's been burning for too long, burning at both ends? Do you leave a small sticky mess on the floor? Do you suffer from premature melting? If so, call this number. It's only $19.95 a second, and we'll come round to your house and laugh at you.
Oh, dear.
Otherwise, phone the psychic's hotline. Hello? I'm not a fucking psychic!
Timey Two Wimey says he had to go back to Castle Grayskull to meet the sorceress.
Stew would be an awesome man-at-arms.
He would.
Hell yeah, son. Time to get a live-action version of He-Man going.
With Stew as man-at-arms.
Stew being the only guy in it. And I'll wear a Skeletor suit.
Awesome.
Yes.
Do I have to film it then?
Maybe. Who can we get to play as He-Man? Timey.
I was going to say Rob Terry.
No, this is low budget.
Yeah, he's low budget.
Fair dues. Rob Schneider. And then He-Man dies 30 seconds in. Take this, Rob Schneider. This is for the animal, whatever the fuck that piece of shit was called.
Oh dear God.
So next
talking
up!
Talking about our plans to kill people.
Next up, Pauly Shore.
Dr. Melski.
I saw Biodome, you bastard!
Dr. Melski, he's off training to replace Shintaro Goto as the new Birth.
I can see that, because it means he gets to be Birth and Iron Man and a Kamen Rider.
Yes, all at once.
Yes. That also means that Birth is Iron Man and Birth and a Kamen Rider. But Stu's also a harem rider, so he'd be Iron Man with a harem. A gaggle of ladies, no less. A flock.
A swog. A swog?
A swog. A swog of whores. What? Hang on.
A gaggle, a swarm, a flock of freaking flights. I do apologise. Beatles Diva says, a Sasquatch has fallen madly in love with Mr. Stew and decided to make him his bride for life. Find him in Sherwood Forest. Since when did Sasquatches live in Sherwood?
Sasquatches go on holiday too!
Okay.
You racist bastard. Hey, you speciesist. What are you going to do now? Start telling the unicorns to stop coming over here, taking our jobs. Say what you like about dragons, at least they make a good curry. Was that the next thing out of you, was it? You species, you make me sick.
Beatles Deeper also says...
Fucking goblins!
Yes,
don't
I know
do a decent day's work for any of them.
I know you like to fuck goblins. While walking down the street, he stepped into a time slip where he's met up with shattered glass versions of yourselves. Awesome. I want to see shattered glass us.
Well, you'd be ugly as sin. And I'd be pretty.
I'd be ugly as sin. You'd be a painfully shy introvert.
I am a painfully shy introvert. What are you talking about? What? What?
Yeah.
Oh, have you ever shown you my penis?
Lazarus says, there is no Dark Ages, there is only Zool.
Yes, there is. For if Dark Ages, if Stu unzips his man suit, out steps Zool from the Amiga from 1993.
The ninja from the nth dimension.
Indeed. There is only him and Chupa Chups. His dimension is running out of lollies, so you must come to this dimension to find their fuel source.
Beatles Diva says he was abducted by grey aliens, and the only way to get out of there is by mastering the art of making crop circles.
I don't want to talk about aliens. I'm scared. All right.
She has added,
and it's her fault.
She has added, if you can't tell, I've been listening to a lot of Mysterious Universe lately. Cheap plug.
Yeah, like they're going to be a successful podcast. They're not going to be like us. You know, we talk about toys. They talk about like weird shit that happens around the world. Fucking saber-toothed lamb or whatever.
Saber-toothed lamb.
I made that up.
I like that. I want to see a saber-toothed lamb. Ah, the cows have been eaten again, Mom. Oh, don't worry. That'll just be our lamb.
That doesn't even make sense.
Is that... I don't know how to pronounce that. Is that Pogue?
Pogue 1100, I think. Maybe Pogue 1100. Or maybe Pogue 1100.
Pogue 1100.
That's the drug that you have to take to help you stop premature melting.
Now that's a drug you have to take to get you off DHD.
Aye. It's like methadone, only it rots your face.
He says he's doing his good deed for the day, changing the diapers of geriatric orangutans.
I want to be like you. Give me a second.
Is there an aging street fighter in the corner next to the orangutan going left and glide?
Yeah. You think you're old? I'm gonna wear a nappy. Your banana hands don't work as well as they used to. What was I saying?
Don Blanco.
Dom.
Oh dear God.
Yes, do we have a winner?
Don Blanco says, whilst masturbating to a picture of Grufflock, snapped his banjo string.
Oh! Oh God, Dom! Oh, why you say that?
That's so wrong.
I mean, the first part is fine, but why the hell would you masturbate to a picture of me snapping my banjo strings? I don't even own a banjo. Seriously, Dom. Why you say that? Why you say that?
Oh dear God.
He broke his penis.
Mr. Lajuta says the rivalry between Grufflock and Dark Ages finally came to a head when Adam had a fit of jealousy, skinned him, and used him as a cloak.
This fancy hat.
So do you
like my stew pants?
Are you actually wearing stew pants today?
I'm wearing stew pants. Skinned and worn.
Elijah Ruta also says he finally reached Twitter overload and collapsed in on himself, becoming the world's first living tweet.
I can see that. I can see Stew living online as like some kind of Kremzeek. Like a mixture of Kremzeek and that gremlin from Gremlins 2. People are on Skype and they just hear the phantom cry in the background of, "Where? I went to the newest of castles." And if you listen carefully, you can hear, "There's a record man."
Jetfire 2009.
Hello, Rob.
Says,
Shattered Glass Rob.
Dark Ages is out pimping your ideas for Transformers 4 to Paramount.
Son of a bitch!
Oh dear.
I can imagine that actually.
Yeah.
I came with this idea. It's called GoBots, Revenge of Dive Dive. For some reason, Stu's put on a really bad American accent. I'm entirely sure what.
I come from newest of castles. I bring you the script.
I bring you the script.
Why do you not read the script? I make this script because I love you.
actually see some bizarre producer going for that if he just presented your script in that way.
Ah, me too. But for some reason, Stu's dressed as Flash Gordon.
Yeah. That will work.
Instead of Flash, it says Stu.
Tricky says, be very, very quiet. He's hunting PCCs.
That could be the case. That definitely could be the case.
With a double-barreled shotgun.
Mm-hmm. I actually think he's going to say, be very, very quiet. You'll disturb him. Kink, kink. I like the idea of Tricky going through long grass hunting herds of stew.
That'd be awesome.
The stew is a strange and unusual animal. Share its traits with both the meerkat and the lion.
Dark Aegis says...
Who's he?
I don't know.
Should we block him?
I don't know. It looks a bit weird.
There's all weird people on this show. Oh, he broke his penis!
Moving on. Dark Ages says, he's at home plotting your demise with Hyno-G's.
Hyno-G's?
Hyno-J-I-I-S.
Oh, it's like your J-I-D. But there's thousands of them. And they're all connected by a hive mind. And
Hyno-J's.
Is that a cross between like a Tyranid, the aliens from Alien, and a J-I-D?
I don't know what's more scary.
Oh, it's the J-I. It's definitely the flocks of J-I as they come round to stab you.
Well, I was thinking about just one J-I-D.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's actually the queen.
Hundreds of J-I-D's.
The other ones are much smaller. The J-I-D that you know. J-I-D? J-I-D. Why do I keep doing that? The actual J-I that you know is the queen J-I.
Hmm.
And the other ones are smaller. The smaller ones have wings.
It's terrifying.
Some of them are MILF? What? Some of them are mint on sealed card. And some of them are in mint boxes. Because when they're born, they don't come out of a cocoon, they come out in like a factory sealed box.
So they're only dangerous if you let them out of the box?
Indeed. If you keep them in the box, they will stay like that for the rest of your life. They look quite nice, but the moment they get out of the box, poof.
It's quite scary.
He's going to stab me now.
Quite possibly. Tricky says, Sally finally launched her master plan. Stu was taken earlier today and is now a hostage of Sal Pentor. Her demands more food.
Recommending is for wussies. Sal Pentor wants the food this she commands.
Yes, indeedy. This is a long one from Tricky. Excuse me. He says, Stu sneezed and a freak reaction caused two quarks to collide, split and form a wormhole in his nose. He was sucked through time and ended up Greece in the 5th century. His naval apparition caused him to jump through time whenever he sneezed. He was observed at many points in time up until about the 15th century. That is why the time period is known as the Dark Ages. His dashing good looks and inability to smell caused many ballads to be written.
That's brilliant!
Although, there's more.
There's more.
Written of his adventures, it is believed that he had but one unfulfilled wish, and that was his next sneeze would be the sneeze hole. So does that mean that Stu became the quantum bastard?
It might do.
That was awesome.
Doodle 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 Do 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 do. Do 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 do.
Oh dear God. Let's try moving on.
But wait, there's more, and this one's a doozy.
Star dubbing.
Ralph
says.
Is it anything to do with Horace goes skiing?
No.
Right.
It says Batman is holding him hostage in a basement. No particular reason, but then Batman needs no reason.
Goddamn Batman. I'm gonna hold Stu hostage because I'm the goddamn Batman. He loves the fact that I'm the goddamn Batman when I hit him in the face with my baseball bat. Because I'm the goddamn Batman. Right now you can call me the goddamn baseball Batman. But that's okay. I don't mind as long as you use the words goddamn and bat. Possibly man.
I'm going to kill you till you die from it.
Why don't you go for Grant Morrison? Go back in time. Kill Grant Morrison just after his JLA run.
Ooh.
Then it's a perfect run.
No, bad ideas. Bad ideas. Stardubbing also says, Horace of the Horace Goes Skiing fame has kidnapped Dark Ages to waterboard him in case he's a terrorist scum.
I have to admit, the idea, I can't remember where he wrote it now, the idea of Horace goes waterboarding had me in evil tears. However, I'm going to replace that. Horace Goes Skiing is no longer about Horace, the computer game character. It's about the Egyptian god. How would Horace go skiing? There's no snow in Egypt. That's okay. He's a god. There's snow now, motherfucker.
He also says...
Well, you don't like the snow? Frogs.
He has been kidnapped by Logan Blaze and taken to a secret chalet in the hills of Switzerland. Terrible things are happening. All I can say is, at least it's not me!
Everybody gets one. You're next.
No! I'm too pretty to have that sort of thing happen to me.
Sorry, I won't touch your face. I have to stroke it lovingly.
That's what I'm worried about.
With his man hands.
So
man
that,
hands.
That is it for the Twitter challenge.
Gonna touch you with his man hands. Because everybody needs good man hands.
Stop now.
Find the perfect way.
I will stamp on your face.
Man hands. All right. Man hands. Needing to be done. Oh, hang on. Miss Slick says... Stu is AWOL because he's had an accident whilst playing with his Kamen Rider belts and he henshined into another dimension. Isn't that a song? Henshined into another dimension?
No.
A song by The Prodigy?
No.
Okay.
Robostrux. Two opposing armies of prehistoric battle beasts. Robostrux. They fear nothing. Robostrux. Monstrous machines with the power to move. Robostrux. From Tomy. They're just looking for a fight.
toys. Mechanoid combat warriors.
Built it, customized, mobilized. It comes to life right before your eyes.
Your skill puts them together. Mechanical precision brings them to life. Build, customize, mobilize. Zoids. Each sold separately. Batteries not included. Assembly required.
Right then, sir. Shall we get some listener questions done and then call this one finished? I apologise for the shortness of the show this week. There's just nothing much going on. Even with our random padding of something.
Stuff.
Yeah. Well, it gives you an idea how much Stu actually pads it out.
Yeah. I mean,
it must just be him.
It's all about Stu.
Yeah, it must just be Stu that makes this show the length it is.
I think when you're, it's going to sound really horrific the way I say this, but when you're bashing stuff off, sort of just two people, you know, it kind of runs its course really fast. I think when you've got a third person there to add something else, mm-hmm. I think it, you know, the random shite just keeps on going.
Very little random shite. Speaking of which, listener questions time.
Ooh, random shite.
Dreadwind. I know him. He does a show. It's called Back to the 80s. You can find it at www.nerdsphere.badmoose.com or www.nerdsphere.blogspot.com. See? Plugged you as well. And he says, because you asked for it. Imagine a universe where Transformers star in 80s game shows. Which ones star in what shows? And what happens? Personally, I can see animated Rodimus doing really well on Bullseye. Likewise for some... Likewise for Soundwave on Name That Tune.
Oh dear God.
So, 80 Transformers in 80s game shows. Thanks, Glenn!
Preceptor as the host of Mastermind.
Nice.
I've started to laugh in. How did you just see Preceptor say that?
So, you are Rodimus Prime, and your
specialist subject
is yourself. Okay.
I thought you were going to say
how to kill Optimus.
I thought you were going to say your name, Rodimus Prime, and your specialist subject, fail.
Failing throughout the ages. Oh!
You've got a good one, haven't you?
I have. Maybe.
Okay.
The game show is Blockbusters. Right? Because if you remember, I might be wrong here, but I'm fairly sure. Blockbusters, if you didn't win, you could come back. Am I wrong on that? Or was it the champion stayed on each time?
I think it was the champion stayed on each time.
That could still work. The champion for this one show... Right?
Yep.
You can see where this is going, can't you? The champion for this one show is Skywarp. Right? Because every time it looks like someone's going to win, he goes back in time and changes their answers. Comes forward in time, he's winning. His contestant is Wheeljack. But they're stuck in a time loop, so each week it's Skywarp versus Wheeljack. And Skywarp keeps winning. And each show ends with the same line. I'm due a win, Bob. I'm due a win.
That's genius.
Was it too long to go into that?
No, I liked it. I'm just...
Yeah? Yeah? Oh,
you just got one.
Come on, then.
What was the name of it? Oh, I can't remember the name of the show.
Mm-hmm.
But Blur would be the host.
Right.
He'd be, tell me all about him! Tell me all about him!
Catchphrase.
No. No, it's...
I think I did a Blur catchphrase. Seriously!
No, it was the... the one with...
Can't even remember the names. The guy's name now.
Bob Monkhouse.
No. Don't know how a dead man in his pool.
Oh, for fuck's sakes. Michael Barrymore.
Yeah.
You're talking that one of the screens, aren't you?
Yeah, the top middle or bottom.
Yeah.
I just got...
Oh, God. Do you realise there are people shouting at their MP3 players at this point?
Yeah.
Their MP3 players and their iPhones. For fuck's sakes! It's cold!
Yeah.
Oh,
answers.
Hotspot.
Yeah. Answers on the forums at www.oldoilhouse.co.uk. And, you know, let us know where we're going wrong there with that one. Because I cannot remember the name of the
It's not coming to me at all.
I just love the
idea. I like the fact that the way you described him was dead man in a pool.
Well, I could have gone a little more abstract with some of the adverts that he'd done.
You could have. You could have done many ways of describing him. The, but no, the, dead man in his pool.
With the blue and white chewy sweets.
Yeah. No. Dead man in his pool.
They're all white, but they're not all white. All white? Some are blue. All white? But yeah, I just love the idea of instead of just saying top, middle or bottom and they're asking which screen they want to go for, you've just got blur running between the two. Top, middle, bottom.
You turned it into like a contact sport, yeah. Basically. He's just running from place to place and you've got to be there ready with him with an answer or else he just runs off again and you lose points. Do you remember Challenge Annika?
Yes.
Imagine Blur Challenge Annika. This week, you've done it.
Yeah. They get the helicopter ready for him and he just runs there instead.
Red alert in Call My Bluff.
What are you at alert?
What are you trying to say about me? Why don't you just talk to me? You can talk. I've gone deaf. Oh, no, sorry, Call My Bluff was the one where you lied, wasn't it? I don't think the one where it's charades. Where you had to do charades.
I can't think of that one.
Although, Call My Bluff would be awesome if there was a quintesson. My first job was a postboy. My first job was a milk boy. My first job was a judge. My first job was killing your parents. My first job was a flower arranger. Which of these quintesson faces is telling the truth?
That's how it was all five.
Yeah. They were all his first job.
I've got it.
Yeah.
It's reusing a character though.
Okay.
It was Big Break.
Right, with Jim Davidson.
With Blaster as the host. And Wheeljack as John Virgo. Trying to set up trick shots, but they always go wrong.
Damn it, Jim.
I'm Joe Wynn, Blaster. I'm Joe Wynn.
Damn it, Blaster. Darren Blaster, I'm a medic, not a winner.
Generation Game with Ratchet instead of Bruce Foster.
I was going to go for the same show, but with somebody else. The Generation Game with Six Shot.
Nice to see you, nice.
What?
Gee.
Can you say that again, please?
A third. Nice to see you. To see you. Nice.
What? Didn't quite catch it. Do you want to move that faceplate out the way, Six Shot?
A third. Nice to see you.
No, this isn't going to run. Cut the cameras off.
Oh. Nobody loves Six Shot.
Do you move on?
Yes.
Northhammer says, hey guys, it's been a while, mostly because I forgot my password and was too scared to ask anyone how to fix it. But you did, didn't you? You sent me an email. Send me an email at theoldoilhouse@gmail.com. Well, by the way, you can send listener questions.
Oh, You see, then I just pictured him as one of the lost Vikings.
It's a shame. I'm not going to say his password out loud. It's a shame that he had to lose his password, because I went to have a look what the old one was and set it up.
Yeah.
But I was obviously gave a new one, and it was freaking awesome. But anyhow, question one. Do Transformers groupies exist? I hope so. See you at AA. Number two.
I hope not.
You are the pretty one. And Logan is grouping towards you.
Precisely.
In a sexy way.
And also, you know, my wife will be at AA, and if there is any pretty Transformers groupies, then that means I can't partake.
But you are the pretty Transformers groupie.
I'm not a groupie.
Not yet. There's a reason Logan's bought stocks in Rip Noll. Anyway,
What?
What? I'm sorry, what? Question two. I feel in love with Marvel 3/3 stuff. After listening to you guys...
Would you like a light on?
No. I feel in love with Marvel...
I think that's supposed to be I fell in love.
Ah, I fell in love with Marvel 3/3 stuff after listening to guys gush about it.
We don't gush.
I think it doesn't say you guys or these guys, just guys. He goes down the working men's club and there's just guys sitting there going, oh, that was a hard day down the coal mines. But you know what makes it worth it? I've got a 3/3 apocalypse. Ah, lad. Aye. 17 hours down the mine, lad. Breathing in coal dust. But I've now got a Deadpool. It's worth it. Well, saying that, though, with the rising prices in oil, I'd probably have to work 17 hours to get a Deadpool.
Yeah.
After listening to guys gush about it, you utter bastards. Oh, thanks. You're welcome. Now I want more. More and more. Mostly, I want the Thundercats stuff that's coming. I want Masters of the Universe in that scale. What would you like to see in that scale? What would you like to see in 3/3 scale? What toy line? I'm going to say Visionaries.
Yeah. Galaxy Rangers.
Tells yeah, son. Yeah. That'd be cool.
Yeah.
Monster in my pocket.
That'd be a size increase in that case.
It would. It really would. And they're not made of rubber anymore.
And
they'd have nothing to do with the original Monster in my pocket, apart from the reuse of the names. I want a Tengu, damn it. I want a Tengu. I love Tengu. Mm. Tengu!
Kamen Rider.
Kind of a...
Are they?
Yeah, there is kind of that scale. They're quite cool.
They're just like some cheap old plastic ones that, you know, I can afford.
Yeah. Oh, hang on. Inhumanoids. Yeah, only humanoids back.
Why SWAT back? Hats.
Nice. Mega Man.
You get the jets.
Oh, Mega Man. But done up like, Batman.
Oh, I said, ooh, Mega Man.
Mega Man, but they're not the cartoony. I'd like to see Mega Man being done in a realistic looking sense in that scale.
You completely thrown me with that one. See, I don't think Mega Man would look as good if it wasn't the cartoony.
It's all like mecha panel lining and stuff, and like the Zero, but just less mangery.
I know. I'd like the mangery 3/3 Zero.
Mm-hmm.
It's with the crazy. Oh, grin.
Not 3/3, but Human Alliance scale. Sari, Sumdac, Fanzone, Fowler. All the human characters that have ever been in Transformers. In Human Alliance scale. That would be cool.
Yeah. That would be quite cool.
Mask. I want Mask back.
Yes, we all want Mask back.
Which is a bit weird because the cartoon's a bit shit, really. Boris the Tsar Bushkin. Good Pitbull.
He was awesome.
Boris Bushkin is the greatest character to ever come out of Mask. Lester Sludge.
He was slime. Genius.
Nobody calls Lester, was it? What are you doing with this no good piece of slime? Hey, nobody calls Lester Sludge slime. Okay, how about no good slime? Question 3. In a get-off, Who wins between Skywarp, Mar-a-Al Uther, and Skeletor? Who's the biggest git of them all? Let's look at this closer. Skywarp is a git because he travels through time, making wrong what once was right.
That's pretty gitty.
Mar-a-Al Uther pretty much can be blamed for anything that's ever happened ever. And Skeletor, well, Skeletor, in my mind, also travels through time, making wrong what once was right, but only in films. Ah! Potter! So which would you say is out of the three? I've made my choice, but I want to hear yours before I say it.
I'm going to go with Skywarp.
Do you know what would happen? No.
What?
Skywarp went back in time, found himself in Eternia. He'd be there, trying to mess some shit up, trying to, you know, get some bits and pieces going wrong. Turns around, and Skeletor's there, and he goes, "Think quick!" Hits him in the face with a battering ram. Where's his entire outfit as a battle suit, attacks Castle Grayskull, gets the power, sits there, sorceress, here is now his bitch. Goes and makes him his tea, goes and makes him his sandwiches. Skeletor likes sandwiches, he does. Ah, ham and butter! You know, that's how Skeletor rolls.
Yep, and the little head that's on the top of Skeletor's throne just kind of grins. And you hear the voice from the distance go, "What a bastard!"
Little Skeletor then gets Skywarp's time-travelling powers and just, even though he's already won, just keeps coming back in time, fucking things up. Not for himself, just little things, like baby Prince Adam. Yeah, has a rattle. Not anymore. Now it's a snake.
Leapaw!
Then Tricky asks, question one. Mega Bloks are doing an awesome job with their Marvel minifigs and playsets. If crayons were sold in the same way, what playsets would you like to go with them? Obviously an Ark and Nemesis, but I'd also like Real Jack's Lab, with real exploding action. I added that bit. A Soundwave for Frenzy and Rumble to pilot, and Red Alert's Closet. What do you...
You'd get crayon babies. Just nailed into the closet.
That's horrific.
Everybody's talking about me again! Can I have to confine myself a baby to skin?
Oh, I love Red Alert. A Soundwave. I love the idea of a Soundwave for Frenzy and Rumble to pilot.
I want Blaster's DJ booth.
Nice. Battle of the Bands. You've got Blaster on one side, you've got Soundwave on the other, right? Both with guitars. And you get like six crayons in the middle to like sit there and you press a button and they decide which one's winning. Yeah. I want
a Prime's deathbed place.
Becomes the button that you're pressing goes, "We Autobots do not have prostates." What you could do,
it comes with a button. And you press it and it's supposed to say the classic line of, you know, "Do not grieve, soon I shall be one with the Matrix." But there was a mix-up at the factory. Instead it says, "Wow, I think I'm going to go out and party. Come on, Barbie." You just get all these kids horrifically scarred from a dying Prime saying that sort of thing.
It looks like Magnus is saying it. Prime's on his deathbed. Tired of party!
That'd be awesome.
What I was thinking there was, you get Prime's deathbed, right, and you get everyone around it, but you get this really evil looking Rodimus with a tiny knife and a big grin, like, "Yeah! I did it!" Ooh! Right. What I would like is some kind of landscape, right? And one side you can put crayon, which includes Springer, and Hot Rod, and Magnus, and lots of people like that, yeah. Blah. Those are even three characters. On the other side you've got Cyclonus and Galvatron, Abominus, Trypticon, and you get Skywarp, right? And it's the Call of the Primitive playset, and it's in thousands, and it costs everything you've ever owned. Failing that, I want Wheeljack with real killing everybody around him action. Just Wheeljack, and then just dead bodies around him. Like one combiner, he's got a leg for a face, and arm for a leg.
He says one phrase.
Kill me! My life is pain!
No, I mean Wheeljack has one phrase.
Yeah, it's a, whoops!
I was thinking more along the lines of, I'm doing Bram.
Question two. With AA a scant 4 weeks away, is there a survival for a newbie to survive the weekend? Do the vendors take cards or just cash? Just cash. I think one or two of them did have cards, but I think it took ages to sort, didn't it?
Yeah.
I think you're better off with just cash. Should you attend every event or just chill out in the bar?
That's between you and whatever god you worship.
I mean, the last 2 years I haven't hit every event.
No, I mean
a lot of the time I've just spent, unless it was something I really wanted to watch, like the Roche Roberts thing from last year, or the Scott McNeil. Scott McNeil's Q&A session, stuff like that. Oh, I didn't eat the Q&A session. He went to the toilet every single time I was there. Then I would say just go to them. Pick out the ones you really want to do. Because, let's face it, the majority of AA is socialising.
Yeah.
It's the entire point of it. Do you leave the hotel at all? Or check out the city centre shops?
We went out for one meal.
Yeah.
But to be honest, we mostly just went across the road, got a takeout, and went back to the room.
Pretty much.
You didn't really need anything else.
Yeah. I went out a couple of times for various bits and pieces. And of course, me, my brother, and Dead Metal, good old Siegfried, we went into one place because I wanted to get some deodorant because I'd forgotten to bring any. And I won a free can of deodorant.
Nice.
In the boots.
Not bad at all.
And the very, very nice woman who was handing them out went, "Hey, yo, are you feeling lucky?" And I just kept giving us the scratch cards. I didn't win anything else, though.
No.
Are the listeners allowed to make eye contact with you hosts? Okay.
Yes, if you're sexy and gorgeous.
Or is there a protocol to follow? Gruff keeps mentioning riding people like ponies. Oh, yes, I do.
I would suggest not trying to ride anyone like a pony. That could get you thrown out.
In all seriousness, though. Shit, come and say hello.
We don't bite.
No. Just come and say hello. We're just guys.
Yeah. We're just guys who talk shit.
Yeah.
In the kitchen.
You listen to us. That, I think, makes you a better man than me.
Yeah.
I don't think I could listen to this. It's rubbish. Yeah, I know he's joking, but yeah, just come and say hello. Now, on the other hand, if you have difficulty in going up to Greg Berger, I understand. I understand completely. But it's alright, because he'll probably come and talk to you.
Sounds like a very nice man.
Burger's freaking fantastic. And that's all the listener questions I've got here. Is there any on the site?
Let's find out.
Let's read on.
I do believe that's all of them. Oh no! We have another!
We have another one?
Yep. From Mr.
Editor.
Shoot, we have two. Mr. Logan Blaze says, guys, great shows, keep it up. If you can't, use Viagra.
Or use DHD, the love drug.
DHD is not for everyone.
Warning, DHD may cause blindness, paralysis, or even death. Please check with your local warlock to make sure you can take DHD in the mouth.
And make sure you pay him well, otherwise he will kill you.
With death!
Logan Blaze says, question one, got an AA shopping list yet? Do you think we will get third-party stuff sold?
Right. As far as I can gather, the majority of stores are going to sell upgrade kits, but not the actual figures. If you want third-party figures, you've got to pre-order them and pick them up at AA. Which I'm not 100% behind, but I can understand why they're doing it, but I just, I'm a little upset because my shopping list was literally going to be those Insecticons and anything else I can pick up. And those Insecticons, some sweeps, some Ratgars.
Just for your army building.
Yeah, maybe some Skystalkers if I can find any. That type of thing.
Yeah.
Because at this point, my Generations line's pretty much done. I was going to keep an eye out for some Masters of the Universe 2002 stuff, see if I can finish that line off. But that's really about it. There's some bits and pieces I want.
I've got...
Vortex. I really want that Vortex.
To be honest, there's only three things on my AA list.
Yeah.
That's a Retgar. Mm-hmm. And a cup.
Have you still not got a cup?
No.
Alright, okay.
I can't find one for about £20. They're all like 25.
Alright, Jesus.
So it's like, I don't want to pay over the odds for a cup when no.
How much are the United ones going for?
I don't know.
Okay.
I haven't really looked, but...
Because I'm thinking, if they're going to be that expensive, you might as well just bite the bullet and get United.
Yeah, I don't want to pay over sort of £20.
Yeah.
But I'm getting the feeling I'm going to have to. But yeah, I want a cup and
the idea cup head.
I would like the cup head, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But I would also like a Hasbro Rodimus even.
Rodimus.
Yeah.
I love that you've just mentioned that you want Hasbro to make a toy of yourself. And you have the sheer audacity to call me the egotistical one. Seriously.
I mixed my words up.
Of course you did. Freudian slip.
It's not like you don't say it all the time.
Oh. Rotter! Rapamus! In the sky!
No, I think that's pretty much all I would really like for AA. I think
beer!
Beer would be a good
beer is on my shopping list.
But I get the feeling that it'd be like last year where I won't be able to get the masterpiece, but I'll end up buying a few extra bits and bobs.
Aye.
But as I say, I've only really got those things that I really, really want. I don't want to make too much of a shopping list because I'll just end up getting disappointed if there's more stuff that I can't buy.
Yeah, I agree.
And Becca's just out for
animated.
Anything animated, so.
Mm-hmm.
He says, question two.
Mm.
We all talk about Marvel and DC animated films / live action, and I know you want an IDW Wreckers direct-to-DVD, but what other comic book universe needs to be animated?
Good question, though, actually. Tell you what I would like to see. Obergeist? Mm, Ragnarok Highway. It was a early 2001-2002, I think. And it's fairly grim.
Hmm.
It's the story of a Nazi scientist who does experiments on people.
Hmm.
The first issue is basically him in one of the concentration camps doing all the experiments, right? But he fails at something. I can't remember exactly how he fails, but he doesn't get the results that his superiors want. So basically they decide, best way of teaching him a lesson? Do exactly to him what he's been doing to everybody else.
Ooh.
Yeah, it's fairly grim. And then he's shoved in a shallow grave with about 40 other bodies. And he just lies there. He's not quite dead.
Ooh.
The soul never quite leaves. But he can't move the body or anything. So he just lies there. For, I think it's 100 years, roughly. just underneath all this. And then when he sort of comes back out as like this zombie creature, he's not allowed to die until he's atoned, basically. And when he comes out in this futuristic, Nazi-ish world, as I say, it's grim going, but it's a really, really, really well-written story, and it doesn't suffer from comic Nazis, which I think is the main point in its favour.
Yeah.
It has no trouble with dealing with the atrocities that took place and letting it breathe and have the weight that it deserves.
So. I think my one's a rather obvious one.
Mm-hmm.
I would actually like to see them do an anime of The Crow, the original Crow graphic novel.
Yeah.
I would love to see that as a proper anime.
That would be cool. Oh! Sam and Twitch!
Yes.
The first Sam and Twitch ongoing storyline, story arc. I can't think what it was called. Just so I could actually hear the words. Why has it got seven things? There's seven things down there. Seven things. You better show this to the mortician. She hasn't seen one of these in years. Fuck you, you fat bastard, just because you haven't seen yours in years. Bendis at his best. That Sam and Twitch. Although, was it Crime Writer? The Writer. The Writer miniseries that Sam and Twitch were in. That's another good one. I'd love to see a Sam and Twitch. Yeah, Sam and Twitch. That's my answer.
I'm trying to think if there's anything else.
Oh! But it would have to have the bit from issue 3. Where it's, they're standing in an alleyway arguing. Spawn, in his only appearance in the entirety of Sam and Twitch, swoops down, comes in, it's all like atmospheric and everything. And he goes, I have need of you. And Sam just turns around and goes, fuck off, we're busy. I think he calls him a dickless wonder as well. It's, yeah, take that Spawn, you shite.
He was so good for like the first graphic novel.
No, he was so good when you were 13.
Yeah. Yeah, quite possibly.
Because when I turned 18 and reread them, I realised that this was a bunch of juvenile, pandering rubbish and Todd McFarlane can't draw for shit. So I gave him to my brother. And when he turned 18, he realised that it was a bunch of juvenile, pandering rubbish and Todd McFarlane can't draw for shit, so he gave him away to someone else. I'm hoping that the cycle continues. Because I had the majority of the Titan reprints.
Yeah.
And I just kept buying them but never read them for about 2 years. And I was like, oh, I better read these. Oh my god, this is rotten.
Is
Ultimate Spider-Man.
Yes.
I've noticed that there's a link here of Brian Michael Bendis.
His Ultimate Spider-Man stuff was awesome. I would love to see that in an anime.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. That'd make a... I suppose it kind of has been made in that weird Spider-Man cartoon, but which was a spectacular Spider-Man.
Mm.
But I want to see just a direct adaption, because that was good stuff. Like the X-Men cartoon was.
Mm.
Pretty much a direct adaption of a lot of X-Men comics.
That'd be good.
Mm.
His third question is, any chance of an old oil house meet?
Yes. Down the line. Because it's something I really would love to do, but unfortunately there are things that are going against it. For a start off, with the lack of people on the forums, I'm unsure of how well it would work.
Mm-hmm.
Myself and Glenn have talked about trying to put something together. That was a while back now. It is an idea and it is something I want to do, but at the moment, it's just not 100% viable. Because I'd hate to set up a meet and then all of a sudden the week before not be able to turn up.
Yeah.
Which unfortunately is how chaotic my life and work are at the moment. Which is a shame.
Yeah. It is a bit. That's it. Bye, he says.
Bye, Logan Blaze. Bye-bye. Bye-bye, Logan Blaze. Bye-bye, Logan Blaze. Come back now.
Liza Ruta has asked a question.
I know him. He says, ate can cheese
you,
once.
Can you three place yourselves in a movie order of leaders, i.e. Optimus Prime, Ultra Magnus, Rodimus? Which of you would be too stubborn to use the Matrix? Which would be too desperate to use it, and which of you would hold out till the end?
Not saying a word of who would be desperate to hold out. Jokes about premature melting. Put it on your head. Cowbell.
So who would you be then?
You see, right. You have to be Rodimus.
Okay.
There's no two ways around that, which means you're my successor when I die.
Woohoo!
Oh, good. Which means...
Hold on a sec. Mm. That means...
You caused my death.
I caused your death, but then Stu succeeds you.
Yes.
But then he just sucks at it, so I win.
Yeah, pretty much.
Sorry, Stu.
Yeah. Blame this bastard here. If it wasn't for him, like, planning with my arch-nemesis Mega Glenn to get me killed.
Mega Glenn.
Jacatron. And then Phil becomes your trailer. Right.
So does that mean I'll just suck at everything from then on?
You're Robert Must Rod. Yeah, man. I've never realised this before. You're pretty. Phil's pretty. You like Hot Rod. He likes Hot Rod. Be a beautiful relationship.
I'm already in a relationship.
Not with Phil. He's going to get married. You are married. Same. It's a match made in heaven. You've got so much in common. You're both men.
Do you both like girls?
You do. There isn't a gay bone in each of your bodies until you meet. And there's a gay bone.
Oh, good God.
Any others?
No, that was it, thankfully.
Right, well, with that, I think it's time to drag this one to a close. Let's have a quick look just to make sure there's nothing else. Right, well, with that, let's say bye-bye to the nice folks at home.
There's a nice
one. All right, let's say bye-bye to the folks at home.
Bye!
Bye, everybody!
Well, yeah. You've listened to the Old Oil House. From this performs at www.oldoilhouse.co.uk. And, yeah. Go over to Facebook. Find us on Facebook. Yeah. And, you can send emails and things to theoldoilhouse@gmail.com. Yeah. Will that do, Brad? Did I win? You can find us on Twitter at the Old Oil House. Yeah. Did I win this time?
Detective. For vengeance. Action.